I've made a copy of ODB11 radio buttons, and I'm calling this ODB12 dates and dollar signs. I've opened up the form to show we're at the point we were at the end of the last video. We've got two dates on here, a start date, which should never change, and our end date that we don't know when that will be, but we do know that we want that to be a valid date. There are a few things we can do to help out the person entering this form make sure that it's a valid date. To look at those, we're going to go into edit mode. So I'm going to close the form and reopen it in edit mode. I'm going to hold down Control and click on the end date text box. Right click, click on Control to open up the properties dialog box. In our list of fields, we can see a min date and a max date. We may want to set those. We also have a date format, which is currently standard short. Let's change that to year, month, day. We can put in a default date if we want, but since we don't know this end date, we don't want to put one in this case. The next one's called spin button. Let's turn that on and see what it does. I'm going to go into edit view. And there's no end date in there now, but if I click one of these arrows, it throws in an end date of 1999, 1201. If I click on one of these arrows, the up arrow increments the day, down arrow decrements the day. If I click on the month, same thing for month, down and up, and same thing for the year. Let's go back into edit mode. No, we don't want to save any changes. Holding down Control, clicking on the end date. Right below our spin button, we've got something called repeat. If I turn that on and go back into edit view, now if I click one of those arrows and hold down the arrow, it will continue decrementing or incrementing the day, month, or year as long as I'm holding down those arrows. Going back into edit mode, going to hold down Control, click on end date. There's one more thing I want to look at, and that is down here at the bottom called the drop down. Let's turn that to yes and go into edit view. I have something selected, so I need to click off all the objects to bring back our labels. And now we've got our spin buttons, but we also have the drop down button. When I click that, it shows us a little calendar. We can click on today, or we can click none to have no date in there. We can click the arrows to the right, takes us to the next month. The left arrow takes us to the previous month. And if I click on the month name, it brings a little drop down for the previous year, current year, or next year. And then I can pick a month in that next year and select a day on the calendar. Let's set the date back to none. And I'm going to save my form, close the form, and save my database. For our start date, that one's not going to change, but we want to change the format of that. I want to grab that same format that's on the table. So I'm going to Tables. I'm going to right-click and edit. And we want to change the format of the start date. So if I click on start date, we see it down in the field properties. Down at the bottom, we've got something called format example. And that's in month, day, year. I'm going to click dot, dot, dot to bring up the dialog box. This will allow me to change the format. So I'm going to make this a date. And I want something unusual so that it will stand out in our minds for our example. I'm going to pick out day, dot, month, year. Clicking OK. We want to save this. I'm going to close the table. And now I'm going to double click on the table and make sure that it came out the way we want. There's our start date. And we see it in day, dot, month, year. It's the way we want on the table. Let's go over to Forms. Right click, edit. We see the start date is still in month, day, year format. We don't want that, so I'm going to hold down Control and click on the start date text box and delete it. Now I want to add something in to replace that, so I'm going over to my form controls and I'm going to click on Formatted Field. And placing that in for my start date, right clicking on Control to open up the Properties dialog box, and I'm going to change the name to FMT Start Date. Going into the Data tab, in the Data field, I want that to be the start date, and then back in the General, I just want this box to look like the others, so I'm going to make my border 3D and the background color is going to be gray 10%. We also want to change the height to 0.25. Now let's go into Design View and see how that looks. And there we have it in the format day.month.year. Going back into edit mode, I'm holding down Control, clicking on Start Date. In our Formatted Field dialog box, we have a field called Formatting. If I click that dot 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 button, we see we've got the number formatting dialog box, the same one we had for the table. So if we don't like the date format there, we can change it, and we've got a bigger selection here than we do with the date box. The difference is, if we have a date text box, we can add the spin button and the drop down, where we don't have that choice for a formatted field, but we have a bigger variety of date formats. I like this as it is, so I'm going to save my form, close that, and save my database. We're calling this video Dates and Dollar Signs, and we haven't seen any dollar signs yet. Let's look at our table. If I right-click and edit this, we don't see any fields that would make good dollar sign values. So let's add a new field. I'm going to call this Hourly Wage. And we want to change this to a format of numeric. We want to change the number of decimal places to 2. And down here we've got a format example. Just like we saw before, let's click on the dot 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 box. And instead of date, this time we want to make this a currency. The default is decimal places 2, lead in 0 is 1. I like that, so we'll click OK. And if you don't change these decimal places and think the formatting will work, it's just going to have 00 for all your values. You don't want that. So make sure you change your decimal places to 2. Let's save this table. Close it. And now we want to double click to change the values on the table. I'm going to scroll right to see my hourly wage, and let's put in some values. I've added in the hourly wage for all of our employees. They're just made up salaries for our made up employees. Let's close this, go back into forms. I want to edit the form. We want to add our new field to our form, so I'm going to click on the Add field. Should be down at the bottom, hourly wage. Click, drag this down to the bottom. I'm going to hold down Control, click on the label part of the field. Right click, open up the dialog box, change the vertical alignment to right. Going to click on the box here on the left side and bring in the box, make it a little smaller. I also want to move this a little bit away from the text box, so I'm going to arrow key to the left. Just one click is good. Hold down Control, click on the text box. From here, I want to change the height to 0.25. I also want to change the border to 3D and change the background color to be gray 10%. We can close our properties box. We can close our add field dialog box. Clicking on the label now selects both fields because they're grouped. I'm also going to bring down our buttons a little bit, so I'm going to select all of them. Just use my arrow keys to bring that down so it's even with the hourly wage. And let's see how this looks by going into Edit View. We don't see our labels because I had something selected, so I need to click off all the objects. And it looks like our hourly wage field turns up fine. So I'm going to save this, close my form, and save my database.